Kidsville Hotel. And you heard the big news? It's buzzing all over town. That's right. Kidsville U, the university around here, is going to a bowl game. Isn't that neat? But you know what's even neater? Some of the hotel residents are going to take a trip to the next town Oversville to watch.
It's a road trip.
Yes, it is, Sheepy. I'm about to make a major announcement. Would you like to go with us?
Why, sure. It sounds like fun.
Well, okay.
I like fun.
Hotel residents, this is Cece, the desk clerk. As we all know, Kidsville U is going to a bowl game, and we are taking whoever would like to go with us on a free trip to support our team. If you want to go, please meet our up at the front of the hotel tomorrow at 6 a.m. Have a blessed day at the Kidsville Hotel.
Yeah. Well, I better take the rest of the day off so I can get ready for the trip. It sure is neat that the team's in a bowl game.
That's absolutely correct, Sheepy. We should all be thankful this time of year, and every time of year, for the blessing of God has given us, He gave us. Well, Sheepy, you see, there's a lot of things that we should be thankful for this year.
You're right, Cece. I just love being thankful.
Kidsville Hotel!
I'm ready to go. Let's go.
Fine, just get in there. Don't forget to buckle up.
This is going to be exciting, Cece.
Yes, exciting and fun. This will be the first bowl game I've ever seen.
Lucy, this is my first one too. So why don't y'all go ahead and get in and find your seats.
Cece, you know what footballs and piggies have in common?
No, what?
Pig skin!
Okay, comedian, go ahead and get in the car. Oh, wait a minute. Bert and Ernie are not here. Won't you go up and get them real quick?
Hey, Kurt. You want to go to the bowl game?
No, I don't feel like it, Bernie.
Don't feel like sitting in the fresh air watching the most spectacular game of all from the stands?
No, not really.
Oh, come on, Kurt. It'll do you some good. 49, 50, hike, hike. What do you say, Kurt, old buddy?
Bernie, I don't want to watch a bowl game and that's fine.
What's the matter?
Nothing's the matter.
Are you feeling okay, Kurt?
I feel just fine.
I don't know. You certainly look a little pale.
What? I look pale?
You do. In fact, your cheeks don't have that usual rosy glow.
They don't.
Your eyes are looking a little glassy.
They are?
Yes. And now your nose. It's kind of flabby. Your ears look run down, and even your hair looks tired.
What? My hair looks tired? Now that's just silly, Bernie. How can hair?
Oh, and your arms.
What's wrong with my arms?
They've lost all their strength. Look, they're flabby and soggy looking.
Leave my arms alone. I tell you, Bernie, sometimes you're a real pain in the neck.
That's it!
What's it?
A pain in the neck. You must have a sore throat.
No.
Open your mouth. Ugh. Let's see. Wider. Wider.
Bernie.
I know what's really wrong with you. You've got the Hungarian measles, or maybe the honking hangnails. Something like that, I'm sure of it. Wait right here.
I don't know what you're talking about, Bernie. Sounds like a whole lot of nonsense. I tell you, he's crazy. Just crazy.
Let me check your heartbeat.
Well, what do you hear?
Ba-boom. 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 Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-boom. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-boom.
That does it. Bernie, that's enough. Now I see what you're doing. I know what you're doing. You know what you're doing. You want me to go to that bowl game, and I can see you're not going to leave me alone until I agree to it. You know what? You want me to go so bad, let's just go. Let's make a big deal of it. Maybe it'll be fun after all.
Oh, Kurt. I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
To tell you the truth, I don't really feel like it now. Maybe I'll just sit and read a nice book. Let's go to the game!
Oh, I'm ready to go watch my alma mater at the bowl game, Cece. Oh, I really like Kidsville U. You know, that's where I got my degree for biblical science.
Well, that's something to be real thankful for, Dr. Nozal.
Yes, it certainly is. He really helped me to get through school.
I'm sure he did. Well, I think that's everybody. Well, we better get going.
On the streets again, I just can't wait to praise the Lord again. The life I love is praising Jesus with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the streets again. On the streets again, I'm going places that I've never been, in the glory of His presence with my friends. I can't wait to get on the streets again and praise the Lord again. Holy Spirit's there as we go down life's highway. We're the best of friends, insisting to the world His way's the right way. Oh yes, the right way. On the streets again, I just can't wait to praise the Lord again. The life I love is praising Jesus with my friends, and I can't wait to be on the streets again.
Lamb4 Sports, it is a game.
It's time for the big bowl game here in next town, Oversville. We've got a great game between Kidsville U and Unthankful State. It's sure to be an instant classic. Welcome to Hidden Filet Stadium. I'm Jim Shorts.
And I'm Harry Pickles.
Harry, we have two teams that have struggled to get to this bowl game. They should be very thankful indeed.
Yes, they should, Jim. Just as I'm proud that my face has been selected to be on the cover of Handsome Face magazine, these two teams can be proud of the way they've competed to get here today.
And what do you think the keys to the game will be?
Well, Jim, each team will need to use good hand-eye coordination in order to deliver that little beauty to its destination. They need to dig deep and lift their instruments of competition, which are chock full of yummy nutrition.
Okay, I'm not sure what that means, but let's meet each school's representatives. Representing the Unthankful State
is Thankless Joe. His characteristics of not feeling gratitude, being generally unappreciative, have been the driving force of his ungrateful team.
Representing Kidsville U will be Fuzzy Lime Jr. He is new to the sport, but has propelled himself to the top in record time. His biggest dream is to become a famous basketball player just like his father, Fuzzy Lime.
Hey, that's my son out there, Fuzzy Jr.
It sure is.
Let's go, Fuzzy Jr. All right.
Woo!
And those are the teams that will compete today. With that, let's get to the game as we go live to the table.
Both teams look ready for the game to begin. Oh look, here comes the box.
I certainly hope they can stomach the challenge ahead of them. This crowd wants milk.
And here it comes. Competitors just need to hear that whistle signaling the start.
Their spoons are lifted at the ready.
And they're off. Let the fur and food fly.
Y'all gonna win. Beat them. Yeah, all right. Yeah. All right.
Look at that, Jim. They really do have their heads in the game.
They sure do, Harry. The excitement is ramping up. Who will win the bowl game? Stay tuned to find out.
Kidsville Hotel!
That was the greatest bowl game I've ever seen in my life. I thought the Unthankful State was going to win, but Kidsville U did a really great job and beat them but good.
Well, that just proves how having an attitude of unthankfulness can ruin your chances of winning in the end.
Yes.
Kidsville U's team looks really happy they won. That's because they're thankful. When we are thankful, others around us will feel how happy we are when we want the same happiness too. You know, this reminds me of a Bible story.
When Jesus saw a big crowd, he felt sorry for them. He healed the ones who were sick. Late in the day, the disciples said to Jesus, "Send the people away so they can buy something to eat." And Jesus said, "They don't need to go away. You give them something to eat." One of the disciples, Andrew, spoke up. "Here is a boy with 5 loaves and 2 fishes. But how can that feed this many people?" There was plenty of grass in that place, so the men sat down. Jesus then gave thanks. The disciples gave the bread and the fish to the people. When all the people had enough to eat, Jesus said, "Pick up the pieces that are left over. Don't waste anything." The disciples filled 12 baskets with the leftover bread and fish. The number of those who ate was about 5,000 men, besides women and children.
That was a good Bible story. This Thanksgiving, try to be thankful for all the things that God, your parents, and siblings have done for you this past year. I bet they'll be thankful for you too. Well, thanks for visiting the Kidsville Hotel. Come back and see us next time. I'm sure we'll have a great time. Bye!
Look! Puma's on the field! Oh, great! And he's fully clothed!
Take a look!
He's clothing!